So I've got a question for you. What is faith? If you are a Christian, then you've probably used the word faith in relation to yourself. I have faith in God. I have faith in Jesus. I have faith in the Bible. You might have been referred to or heard Christians referred to perhaps as people of faith, or that you're a person of faith. But if someone were to ask you, okay, can you define faith for me? A lot of people have difficulty with this. And I think part of the reason for that is that there tends to be a disconnect between what faith actually is and the way in which faith is caricatured by our culture at large. In fact, Christians are often thought of as people who believe in fairy tales. And faith is usually thought of as something of a blind faith. We're taking a leap of faith. We are placing faith in something that we don't have evidence for, is the way it's normally depicted. But in fact, this couldn't be farther from the truth. In fact, so many ways in which God has provided evidence for us is available to us today. Think about it. Everything that God did happened in time and space in human history. And we have eyewitnesses who have recorded these things throughout history, in which we have record of in the scriptures. There's also archaeological evidence for the things that the scriptures claim. We have corroborating evidence for the claims of the gospel writers, and Paul and others of the writers of the New Testament, writings in Roman sources and Jewish sources from the time period, that demonstrate that what we come to believe is actually based in truth. So what is faith? Faith is actually making a commitment, taking a step of commitment in that which we know to be true. Because there's always a point at which we have enough knowledge, we have enough evidence, but we still have to then place our commitment where the evidence points. I'm reminded back to when I first became a Christian. I was 16 years old, and I had attended a church for the very first time on an Easter Sunday morning with a friend of mine. And at the end of that sermon that was preached that morning, I heard the gospel message clearly. Because of the death and the resurrection of Jesus, those who believe in Jesus will not have to spend eternity separated from God, but will be able to spend eternity with God in paradise. Now that sounded like great news for the Christians in the room. For me, who didn't yet believe in Jesus, this was scary news. In fact, I had to know if this was true because it had eternal implications for me. And so I remember going home with a Bible that somebody had given me that day. I read pages and pages and pages, books and books within the Bible, and asked questions of anybody I could get my hands on over the course of the next several days. On Thursday, following that Easter Sunday morning, I went to the same church again for a small group meeting. And after the small group, I was sitting down, kind of thinking through all the things that were going through my head in this whirlwind between Sunday and Thursday. And the small group leader came up to me and said, "Kevin, are you ready to place your faith in Jesus?" I said, "I don't know. I still have so many questions." And she said, "All right, what questions do you have?" And as I sat there thinking through any questions I could wrap my mind around, I realized something. That I have read enough, that God had revealed enough to me, that I had sufficient answers to the many questions I've been asking for the last several days, and my seeking questions at this point was trying to put off the inevitable. Because in my heart and in my mind, I knew this was true, but I was hesitant to actually commit myself to it. And in that moment, God revealed exactly what I was doing, and I said, "Yeah, I don't really have any questions, I guess." And she said, "Well, that settles it, doesn't it?" And right there, I placed my faith in Jesus and gave my life to him. And you know what? It's not that every question I could ever possibly ask was satisfied. It's that I knew this to be true, and therefore I had to take a step of faith. Not faith in something that didn't make sense, not faith in something that was not evidenced, but faith in the evidence. And you know what? While we don't have all the answers to all of our questions when we place our faith in Jesus, ever since that moment when I did place my faith in Christ, all the questions that have come up since then have been answered satisfactorily, or I've had the ability to know enough about God and have experienced him and know enough about the truth of his nature that even those questions that I don't have answered, because of the answers I do have to other questions, I could trust that there are answers to some of those questions that I don't have answers to. And so faith is not something blind. Faith is putting your faith in the evidence, and by God's grace, he has provided sufficient evidence. An analogy that I often use in talking about faith is this. It's like walking into a room you've never been in before, and you see a chair that you've never sat in before. You don't know who constructed it. You don't know how old it is. You don't know anything about the chair. But when you look at it, it's got four legs. It's got a seat. It's got a back. It seems like it would hold your weight. And at some point, you have to make a decision to sit down in that chair. Now, the chair might give way, but all the evidence seems to the contrary, that it will, in fact, hold my weight. Now, if that chair had only three legs, if it had a big wad of gum in it, I wouldn't sit in it. But finally, I have to take a step and sit in that chair. And that's what faith is. You size something up. You look at the evidence. You see that everything points in that direction. You may not have all perfect knowledge about it, but you have enough to know it's true. And so you are responsible to take that step of faith and make a commitment to it. And so that's what we do as Christians. We see the evidence. We see the scriptures. We see the eyewitness accounts. We see God working in our lives, and we take a step of faith, not blind faith, not a leap of faith, but placing faith in that which we believe to be true. And we're rewarded for it in our relationship with Christ.